जनिके लाला महाबलवान,
जनिके लाला महाबलवान,
जनिके लाला महाबलवान,
जनिके लाला महाबलवान,
गजाननम् भूतगणादिसेवितम् कपित जम्बु फलसार भक्षणम् नुमासुतम् शोक विनाशकारणम् नमामि विघ्नेश्वर पाद पंकजम्। या कुंदेन्दु तुषार हार धवला या शुभ वस्त्रावृता या वीणा वरदंद मंदित करा या श्वेत पद्मासना या ब्रह्माच्युत शंकर प्रभृति भी देवै सदा वंदिता सामां पातु सरस्वती भगवती सामां पातु सरस्वती भगवती निःशेष जाड्यापः गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरुनाथ महाराज की जय। आओ गुरुदेव दर्शन दीजो
दर्शन दीजो
आओ गुरुदेव दर्शन दीजो
आओ गुरुदेव
जग के दाता। Bye. I should have told you in the beginning, but I'll tell you now also. Never too late. When you get a chance to chant the name of God, Shri Ram Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, don't miss it. That is just like getting an opportunity to put some money in the bank, you know. The money will be there. So each name we chant, we have a ledger of Punya Karma, it is called. Ledger of Punya Karma. So each name we chant, that goes into the ledger there. Some people ledger blank. It has nothing. Or it only has Papa Karma. In the 16th chapter, two ledgers are there. Punya Karma, what is it called? Daivi Sampat and Asuri Sampat. All the other ledger full. But this ledger, you get an opportunity, do something good, and you come to satsang, and name is being chanted, don't miss the opportunity. Means you open your heart and, as they used to say, gay abandon. Chant the name of God. Okay, now, I told you on the 18th, 19th and 20th of October, we are resuming our Kabir Yajna. We are taking verses from the great teachings of Sant Kabir Das. Well, here are some verses from Kabir Das. Let me tell you meaning first and then we'll sing one or two. Right? And to hear the rest, you have to come in the Yajna. Chalti chaki dekh kar diya Kabira roy. Kabir Daji went to somebody's house one day and he saw chaki. Chaki means a jata. In the old days, they have a jata in the house. One round stone on top of another round stone. And the top one used to have a handle like that and they used to spin that top one. And all the grains they used to put in the middle because in the middle had a pole. Middle of the stone had a hole, two stones, and then one pole running like this to keep the two stones together. So in that middle there, they used to put grains. And the grains used to get in between those two stones. And when this top one is turning like this, he used to grind it and throw it out on the outside like that. Yes. Jata is to call here. Well, in Kabir Daji's place, it's called Chaki. So he saw this Chaki. So, Chalti Chaki dekh kar. So, Diya Kabira roy. He cried. When somebody asked, what are you crying for? You see Jata and you crying? He said, Do Pathan ke beech mein साबुत बचा न कोई द जीव यू एंड आई वी आर लाइक दैट ग्रेन वांट दैट ग्रेन गो रॉन्ग दे राम नाम ही कमिंग आउट ऑफ पाउडर ओनली नथिंग लेस इजंट इट नाउ यू सी वंस वी कम इन दिस वर्ल्ड With its pairs of opposite, joy and sorrow, good and bad, right and wrong, rich and poor, high and low. Are we coming to this world? We coming out here, out of this world, like powder only. You ever see anybody come out otherwise? If you go to Shore of Peace, cremation site, you come out to powder. If you go down below, dust. What is the difference? 6 feet below, still powder in the end, isn't it? Nobody here coming out of this world? They say you could never come out of this world alive. Unscathed, nobody will come out. Kavidaji cried because this is the condition of the jiva. Jiva means the individual. His condition is like this. This is how he comes, how his state in this world. Chaki chaki sab kahe, aur kili kahe na koi. Jo kili se lag rahe, uska bal na baka hoy. This is a very difficult language of that time. What he means to say, everybody talks about the chaki, that wheel. But do you know that kili? Kili is the pole in the middle. In the middle, there's a pole that holds the two stones. That pole doesn't go anywhere. Eh? If any grain stay near that pole, if any grain stay by the pole, he wouldn't go under, between the two stones and he wouldn't get powdered. That pole is like Bhagawan. This is the idea. That pole in the middle is like, if anybody stay in the 7th chapter of Bhagavan, Bhagavan says, 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, yeah, he says, mam maya duratyaya ye mam prapadyante, those who take refuge in me, they cross over this maya, the one who take refuge in me. And there the rishis describe, you know, in the old days here, all the people decided they would know what they are talking about. Listen to this. I used to see that regularly. See all of them. I used to see all them fellas who are a little bit older than me and thing. They have net and thing. And there's a hole is net so. I used to only get to see that. That net is heavy. The lead and thing are heavier than me. So I can't lift up that thing. So they say, take that net and throw like that. Any fish outside there, he dog's dead. I don't know if he was a dog. He fish dead. I said dog dead. But if that fish leave over there, and this man standing in the water, and if that fish come by his foot, that he wouldn't be caught, isn't it? If that fish leave there and come by his foot, when he throws so, he wouldn't be caught. In the same way, Bhagwan's maya, which makes up this dvandva, pairs of opposites in which we are caught, young and old, rich and poor, we are caught in this pairs of opposite. And usually the person who is on this side, he want to go to the next side. And the one who is the next side, he want to come this side. You see, peculiar thing about human being? So Bhagwan's maya is like that. That net, you throw, but the fellow who lives there and takes refuge on the feet of the Lord, he will not be caught in this maya. In 7th chapter, Bhagavan is yetham mam prapadyante maya metam tarantite. They cross over this maya, the one who takes refuge at the feet of the Lord. Well, Kavidaji is saying, if that grain stays by that pole, because the pole is not moving, it is the stone which is moving. If he takes refuge there, that stable, achalam it is called. Stable element in the universe is God only. Everything else is chalam. Chalam means coming and going. But Bhagavan is achalam, unmoving. And so does that pole. He says, he who takes refuge at that pole there, which represents the Lord, uska balena baka hoi means he will not be subjected to death. He will not be subjected to all the vagaries of this world. These are some of the verses of Kabirdaji. Let us see this thing, you will see. Thank you. चलती चाकी देख कर सो दिया कबीरा रोय। So crazy. Everybody so crazy in the world. Inter. Duniya kitni bhavari.
Duniya kitni bhavari.
Duniya kitni bhavari.
Duniya kitni bhavari.
Jo patthar pujan ja.
Jo patthar pujan ja.
Oh, duniya kitni bhavari. Jo patthar pujan ja. Worshipping stone. Everybody worshipping stone. Stone murti, stone lingam, stone everything. But the chaki, grinding the grain, that chaki grinding the life out and giving me food. But nobody are worshipping that chaki. Chalti chaki dekh kar so diya kabira ro.
Chalti chaki dekh kar so diya kabira ro.
Do paathan ke beechya.
Do paathan ke beechya.
Paathan ke beechya.
Do paathan ke beechya.
Saapat bacha na koi.
Kabira
saapat bacha na koi.
Yeah.
doin japa andi mala talking to him now japa mala talking to him
mala kahe hai kaat ki
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 tu kya bheerat mohe
tu kya bheerat mohe
tu kya bheerat mohe
tu kya bheerat mohe
man ka man ka bheer de
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 surat mila tu to he
surat mila tu to he
of Kabirda ji. The mala tells, are you turn in mala. The people who do japa, the mala talking to him. You turn in mala. Turn your mind. Your mind only going here and there. You know, mind only going outside. Turn it inside. Now, if you are joining us tonight for the first time, we are seeing our most wonderful dialogue going on in the a most wonderful story, katha, going on in the Balkand, Shiva Parvati Samvad. Now we'll do the Sumiran and then we'll see.
Jo Sumirat Sithi Hoi Tan Nayak Kari Dar Vadana
great lord of the world, Bhagwan Shiva, who is called as Mahadev, with his consort Sati, went to the great sage Agastya Muni to listen to Ram Charit, to listen to the stories of Rama. And after having listened, the sage asked Bhagwan Shiva about bhakti to Ram. The sage told the stories of Ram, and Lord Shiva told about bhakti or devotion to Ram. Shrota, Vakta, they exchanged, listener to speaker, and they had a very good time and they left. But Bhagwan's consort, Sati, seemed not to have had much faith in that whole story because there is no description of the joy which Lord Shiva felt after listening to Ramcharitamanas, after listening to the Ram Katha, Sati did not feel the same, it looks like. And then Bhagwan Shiva another time went to get the darshan of Bhagwan Ram in the forest when he had just lost Sitaji and he was walking and crying. And Sati again got a big doubt. But do you know, these are two doubts, two great big doubts. One in the Balkan, which is starting of the Ramayana, and one in the Uttarkhand, which is the ending of the Ramayana. There, the great Garud has a doubt and goes to Lord Shiva. And Lord Shiva sends him to Kakabushundi, and that makes the whole Uttarkhand. There he had a doubt also. Because on the battlefield, he saw Bhagwan Sri Ram caught with the Nagpash. And he was thinking, if he's the Lord of the world, how he get caught? He's supposed to release us from bondage. I had to come and release him from bondage. What kind of thing is this? So Garud gets a doubt. And he goes to Bhagwan Shiva to remove his doubt. Bhagwan Shiva sends him to Kak, that is there. So the doubt leads to, see, when there's a doubt only, let me tell you something. Doubt is good, like they say. Doubting is good. Doubting Thomas. Because only when we doubt something, and I told you, doubting with Shraddha Sahit, doubting with proper faith, then we'll start looking for answers. If we doubt without faith, that means we are doubting with arrogance, then nothing will come out of it. But doubting with faith is good. We start looking for answers. When questions start coming in the mind, we start looking for answers. And sometimes we make the wrong choices, as Sati did. As we saw, she went there to test Ram. She didn't believe that this is the Lord of the universe, you know. Lord Shiva told again and again, she didn't believe that thing. So she went there to test. And then after thinking also, because Shraddha Rahita, she didn't have proper Shraddha in her heart, faith. She gave the wrong test. Sometimes you give the wrong, one teacher asking that boy, he say, if I have 10 oranges and I get 5 more oranges, teacher asking in the class, if I have 10 oranges and I get 5 more oranges, what is my age? The boy expecting if I have 10 oranges and I get 5 more, how many oranges I will have? He expecting that question, that kind of test. You know, if I have 10 oranges and I get 5 more oranges, what is my age? So that boy said, sir, your age is 40. So the teacher said, what? How you get out of that? You really was 40. How you get out that from this, you know, this information and this question and all? He said, well, at home, I have a brother, and he half as mad as you, and he's 20. I mean, you have to be 40. If I get 5, if I have 10 and I get 5 more, how is my age? Wrong test. Sati went and gave the wrong test to Rama. She took the form of Rama's wife. Hare Rama. And then when she came back also, and Lord Shiva asked, you gave test? No. No. I do pranam just like you. And in any case, you did tell me why I could doubt you. But that's why she went in the first place, isn't it? You tell me that was the Lord of the universe. But anyway, Lord Shiva realizing that she took the form of the wife of Rama and went in front of Rama. And Rama is like my own father. And Sita is like my own mother. So Lord Shiva dropped her. And he went into dhyan for 87,000 years. Samadhi mein lag gaye. 87,000 years ke liye. Then after he came out, she saw so many Pushpaka Viman going. So she asked Lord Shiva, what is going on? Well, he told, your father is having a yajna. And he invited all his daughters, but he didn't invite you. So I don't think you should go there. She wanted to go. He said, I don't think you should go there. Well, in any argument between wife and husband, one fellow was saying, telling a friend, he said, last night, me and my wife arguing. She's saying, let me go and see a movie. I say, let me go out for dinner. She's saying, let me go out and see a movie. I say, let me go out for dinner. The friend say, so what movie will you see? That means to say, what the wife saying that will happen? The wife gone, in spite of Lord Shiva saying, advising. But when she went there, she was gravely insulted by what she saw. And she got so angry with her father and all the gods who had gathered there and everybody that she burnt her body in the fire of yoga. Yoga, Agni. She burnt her body right there and then. And Tulsidas, she described in a very fast-paced moving story at that point. She is born in the house of Himavan, the lord of the mountains, Himachal. She's born in his house. And then from the moment she's born there, there is prosperity flourishing everywhere. Even the mountains started giving out their own gems and jewels and all of that sort of thing. So it means the coming of this most divine child into the house of Himavan brought with it an immense amount of prosperity and wealth and so many things. The trees started flowering, fruit started bearing, every river started flowing nicely with more, everywhere, abundance. And I told you, these things run in deep into the fabric of societies everywhere. We have seen here, we used to talk about that in the old days. When this son of mine born, everything started to go good that time. You heard? That thing is still there in Hindu families. When this son or daughter was born, everything started to go good that time. So anyway, those type of things we hear. So in this case here now, it happened that everything flourished nicely in Himavan's kingdom when Parvati was born there. Sarita sabapunita jalu bahahi. This is after number 65. Khaga mirga madhupa sukhi sabarahahi. Sahaja bayaru sabajivana tyaga. Giri para sakala karahi anuraga. Means even the animals in that kingdom of Himavan, her father, even the animals dropped their natural enmity towards each other and every one of them started living together like that. Also, and Sarita sava punita jalugahadi. Rivers gave nice pure waters and all such wonderful description is there. So hasaila girija griha aye jimi janu ram bhagati ke paye. The joy came to the heart of Himavan like when a devotee gets bhakti for Ram. He's trying to develop devotion and then devotion suddenly floods his heart. Or joy comes to his heart. Like that, Himavan became so joyous. Nitanu tena mangala grihe tasu. Brahma dika gavahi jasa jasu. And every day some new joy came, some new pleasure came to that kingdom. And Brahmaji and all the gods also sang the praises of Himavan. Oh, Himavan is so lucky. He got Jagat Janani to be born in his house, ityadi, all this, that, all. What a flourishing kingdom. And it's a Nar Samachar. Now from there we'll start. Narad heard the news now. What? Jagat Janani Parvati ji is born in Himavan's house, in that kingdom. Narad now, see.
नारद समाचार सब पाए श्री राम जय जय राम जय जय राम। हित मुनि पद सिरुना
रामचंद्र की जय। नारद समाचार सब पाए, नारद got the whole news because everybody singing the praise of him one, all the gods, ब्रह्मा जी also, him one so lucky, जगत जननी born in his house, the mother of the universe born in his house, so then नारद heard the news, तुलसीदास जी told the story is very fast, तुलसीदास जी slows down at certain times when you don't expect him to slow down. And other times when you expect him to slow down, he speeds up. In the same line, Narad had the news, the same line, he reached Himavan kingdom too. That story so fast. Kautu kahi giri kahe sithaye ageha sithaye means he found himself in the house of Himavan to see the spectacle. He wanted to see also when the divine mother herself has taken birth in the house of Himavan. Then, Saila Raja Bar Adar Kinha Padapakari Bar Asanuddinha. The king Himavan, Parvati's father, now, say he's called Saila Raj. Bar Adar Kinha, he respectfully welcomed this Narad and put him to sit down and padapakari vara asanu dinha, washed his feet and everything and gave him a nice seat to sit. The traditional things. Nari sahita muni pada siru nava. And then after that, washing the feet and all, he and his wife together, and these are all traditions, all wonderful traditions. Many, many people still keep. It's good. Bowing down to any great sage like this and all, the wife and husband are supposed to go together. You can't go tell your wife, go bow. And people tell children also, go. Yes, Amiji, come in and go and bow, come to you. Like some parents tell like that also. The parents have to be the example for the children. And bowing down is a great, great thing in our tradition. Bowing is a great, you know what happens? Bowing is a sign of surrender. Surrender. In Hindi, sar means head. Andar. Sar andar is surrendered. You know, you put the head down. But what it does, it makes the heart receptive to higher knowledge. It makes the heart receptive to the higher understanding which is there in the Shastras. But the heart that is like that, look here. We see this. In Sanskrit, there's something called Tiryang. Tiryang means those beings in the world who spine like this. See, dog and cow and bull and all, they spine like? They're called Tiryang. Human spine? Isn't it? and you could ever have more love than a dog? Any animal you train, those animals have unconditional love for us. Eh? Because their heart and their head is same level. But human head higher than he? That head too much on top. Right? The heart could never develop love. The head always taking precedence, isn't it? But this dog, his head and heart have the same. That dog will have unflinching, unconditional love for you, for the master. In the morning, I tell you, you beat that poor fellow when you're going to work. In the morning, you give him a beating when you're going to work. And the evening, when you come back from work, he's still wagging his tail, isn't he? He welcoming you, isn't it? You still your waggy tail like that. You try that thing with your spouse. Yeah? In the evening, when you come back, you have no spouse and no house too. But, yeah. So, the animals, they know unconditional love better than human beings. So when we bow, we bring our head even lower than our heart. Because it is the head where the Abhiman is. The Abhiman is in the head. We bring that Abhiman down, surrender it to the feet of the saint, the sage. See, the king and his wife both. And together, they bow down to the... See, this is just all about bowing and all that, all right? We have dealt with this topic in our Varsha Pratipada Sansad in some of the previous years and all. Nadi Sahita, with his wife, the two of them bow down. And then, Charana Salila Sabhavanu Sichava, the both of them, they took the water from which they washed his feet. It's an old tradition also, and they sprinkled it in the house everywhere. Then, Nija Saubhagya Bahuta Giri Barana. And then the king counted his blessings. What a great blessing it is. The great sage, Deva Rishi Narada. He's not an ordinary Rishi from here. He's a Rishi among the Devas. Not a world, earthly Rishi. A Rishi from the Devas themselves. Deva Rishi is called. Brahmaji's mind-born son. He came to my house on this very auspicious day. Suta boli mele Girija, Girija mi Parvati. She has already grown up a little bit. A few years. So he called, we tell to all the attendants, bring the Parvati here fast. So they brought Suta Boli Meli Muni Charana. And he also now made Parvati bow down to the sage, Narad Rishi, Narad Muni. And she also bowed down. Trikala Gya, Sarva Gya Tuma. Then the king, Himavan, he told to Narad, my dear Narad, you are the knower of past, present, and future. You know all things. Sarvagya. Sarvagya means that word I told you on the previous day. You are all knowing. He knows everything. Even that thing that he might not know, he knows because he travels everywhere. Isn't it? He finds himself. Now see, he come here. Nobody I invite he to. He also come there. Sages have license to go. Anyway, you can't tell a sage, no, you can't go here and can't go there. Of course, some places they should not go, but you can't tell him he can't go. So, gati sarvatra tumhari. It means you know the destiny of all people and all things. My dear Narad, Himavan, the father of Parvati, is telling, kahahu, you please tell now. Kahahu, you tell. Suta ke dosh guna munibara hridaya vichari. You please now look at my daughter and tell all her future, good things and bad things also. You will have to tell. Because you can only tell, people are only want to hear good thing. Eh? Look here. I have so many questions about this, and people are go to read Patra and read, longer they call read planet. This Patra and that astrological chart and this thing and that thing, people like them thing too bad. And now, the thing with that, right? Number of things with that. One is, People only like to hear good things. So now the people who are reading it also, he has to tailor the message in such a way that it don't sound too bad. Isn't it? And almost invariably when you go, you go hear that you have a grah. Correct or not? And there are people now, other people, they don't even go. The other one, he had gone. And this one who gone, he telling that one, you have a grah. This grah thing has become very, very strong. And people believe strongly in all of these type of things. Look here. Whatever karma we have done in the past, that karma will come whether you jump high or jump low. Correct or not? So then, what you go do? Some people say, no, if I know that it's coming, I go brace myself now. I'll make a little bar. So that might be okay. That might be a fair comment and all. If you know there's something coming. But you know what happens with that? Where's the problem with that? Suppose I know that when I reach, say I'm 10 years old, and I go and I read this thing. I'm 10 years old. Now Baba tell me, when you reach 20, you're going to have such and such calamity in your life. Well, I go start to worry from 10. And I mightn't reach 20. Yeah, stress, the kind of stress you get there. So better you live your life happily 19 until 20 when it come, because karma had to come in any case, isn't it? Those kind of things, that is the problem. But anyway, that still remains a personal choice, correct or not? That still remains a personal choice. Why I want to know what is going to come there when that thing come, I worry from 10 years before. I might not make the 10 years. So, anyway, Himavan now asked, you tell about this Parvati now, good and bad. Well, once you ask the sage, and he just called it Trikalagnya, he knows all three periods, past, present, and future. Sarvagnya, he's all knowing. So now Narad is going to reply, tell about the astrological chart of this child, Parvati.
Kaha muni bihasi kur mridu ba.
Yeah.
रामचंद्र की कह मुनि बिहसी व्हेन आई सी द किंग आस्क्ड नारद टेल अबाउट दिस चाइल्ड्स ब्यूटी एंड गुणन बट टेल अबाउट द नेचर ऑफ द चाइल्ड लक्षण एंड क्वालिटीज एंड व्हाट हाउ शी विल बी नारद लाफ्ड Narada laughed because he knows parents only want to hear the good things. And anyway, kaha muni bihasi, gura mridu bani, and very deep, profound words, but very softly now Narada told. Suta tumhari sakala guna khani, your daughter is the very storehouse of all great qualities. Which Jagat Janani, what else it will be? She was playing one role there, in that Purva Janma, previous life. Now she is coming to play another role. Yeah, but she's all in all, she is the very storehouse of all great qualities. So, sakala guna khani, sakala means all. Great qualities. Sundara sahaja susila sayani. Beautiful she is. Sahaja susila, naturally good-hearted and amiable, friendly. And Sayani, wise. How are all great qualities? Now, why, when these qualities are given, there's a principle which is told in Sanskrit, but it's called as Siddhakasya Lakshanani Sadhakasya Sadhanani. Means whatever are the great qualities of the great ones, those become the pointers for us. Means we have to develop those qualities. But I may not have it, but I have to develop that. The qualities are pointed out, not just like that. They are pointed out as goals for us to reach. So she's naturally wise. Wise. There are two types of people in the world. Those who are wise and those who are otherwise. So she's wise. We have to be. And Susil means very friendly and amiable, good-hearted and kind, you know, like that. She is. Naam Uma. She'll be called as Uma. Parvati called as Uma, so several names. Ambika! Uma, Ambika! Bhavani! All these names. Parvati! Narada told three names only. Uma, Ambika, Bhavani. Sabalakshana Sampanna Kumari. This little princess will have all great lakshana. Long ago, you used to hear that word? In the house, Kulachan, yeah. It would come from Ramayana only. If you grow up in this area and nobody called you Kulachan, they call you nothing, you know. You see, the Sanskrit word is Lakshana. Lakshana means qualities, traits, characteristics. Lakshana. Sulakshana means good qualities, traits, and characteristics. Kulakshana. In Sanskrit, anything you want to make good, you put su. Anything you want to make bad, you put ku. So sulakshana means all good qualities, traits, and characteristics. Kulakshana. That's why they call it kulakshana in the house. They call it barak kulakshanba. In Bhojpuri, you have to tell. Barak kulakshanba. So the in Awadhi, in this Bhojpuri Awadhi and all, it is Lachan in Sanskrit, Lakshan, like that. So he said, this girl, this little princess, has all the great qualities. Lachana Sampanna, endowed with all great qualities, like that. Kumari, Hoihi Santata Piyahi Piyari. And she will be loved by her husband. The Indian families like that kind of thing, eh? She will be loved by the husband tremendously. They will have great love between wife and husband when she gets married and all that kind of thing. Then, sada achala ehi kara ahi vasa ehi te jasu pehahi pitu mata. Means to say, ehi vata pitu mata. Means she will have very happy married life and she will bring great glory to her mother and father. No, parents like to hear all them kind of thing. ओही पूज सकल जग माही एही से वत कछु दुर्लभ नाही मीन्स शी विल होही पूज सकल जग माही एंड एही से वत एनीबॉडी सर्व्स हर एही से वत कछु दुर्लभ नाही मीन्स देयर नथिंग व्हिच दैट पर्सन विल not be able to attain in the world. You know, the Jagat Janani, if anybody worships the Jagat Janani, then nothing which that person cannot achieve or attain. That the mother is soft-hearted now. Look here, long ago, when you want to do something, when you want something, when you want to go somewhere, who is to ask, mother or father? Mother, if you ask father, he said, hey, sit down right there. If you ask mother, Don't worry. Just now when your father go there, you go. Soft-hearted, tender-hearted mothers are so much of affection for that child. So anybody who serves Jagat Janani, the mother of the universe, anything that person wants, that person will get that immediately. That is what the line tells. He say, what's a kachu durlabh nahi? Nothing will be difficult to get. Ehi kara naam sumiri samsara triya charhi hai pati vrata asi dhara. That any woman who remember this Parvati, Uma, and any woman who remember, wives who remember this Parvati, they will become the Pativrata. Pativrata means, in English there is no word for this, you know. How to tell that? They will have unflinching fidelity to their husband. Anybody who remembers Parvati will have unflinching fidelity. 100% fidelity. Even though Tulsidas puts a line there. What is that? Even though it is Asidhara, even though that thing is as difficult to tread as the edge of a sword, especially in this Kali Yuga time. So, he says, anybody who remembers Parvati like this, Saila Sulachana Suta Tumhari, my dear Himavan, Narad says, your daughter has all these great qualities, but Sunahu Je Avaguna Dui Chari. In English, we say 2-3. In Avadhi, we say 2-4. Dui Chari means 2-4. The language culture a little bit different. Dui Chari means 2 or 4. We in English we don't say 2 or 4. Listen to 2-3. Yes, 2 or 3 we say like that. Now listen to a few of the other side. No, I know you don't like to hear that, but listen. What is this? Means all I just told all her fortune and good side. Now listen to the other side.
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Shri Ram Jai
life is made up of pairs of opposites, you know. And you can't have one without the other. If there is positive, there will also be negative. You ever see a bicycle with one pedal? The bicycle have to have two pedals. A bicycle with one pedal will go away. It can't go. You need two pedals. Because when that one pedal go forward and there is no pedal like this. So, the thing that makes life go around is the pairs of opposites. You see, even any turbine, any motor, there's positive and negative. Two wires have to go. You see, two wires, positive and negative wire, that only that motor will. So the world works with the pairs of opposites. So, Narad told all the positive things about Parvati. Now, fortunately, the negative thing is not so bad. Now, listen to it. He says, Aguna, Aman, Matu Pitu Hina, Udasina Sabha, Samsaya China, Jogi Jatila Akama Mana, Nagan Amangala Besh, Asaswami Ehikaha Milehi, Pari Hasta Asi Rek. My dear Himawan, sorry to tell you. But now when I look at her hands and I see those lines, people like that also. Read the? And I know that better than because when I travel in through immigration anyway, and people see this clothes. They put out that hand to read it. So Narad say in Parvati's hand, now listen to what type of husband she will get. That's where written there. Narad telling, that fellow, he will be jogi. Jogi means, he really is a wanderer here and there, jogi. Right? He only engage in yoga. Yoga, he wouldn't pay any attention to she. He only engage in yoga. Jogi. Then Jatil. Jatil means he'll have this big matter here like this. Jatil. Then Akama. Totally desireless. Totally desireless. He want a wife, he want a children, he want nothing. So much so. Akama mana? Nagan. He want no clothes too. Nagan means naked. He want to close with so desireless, he want to close also. Nagan. Then, Amangala Vesh. And if he wear anything, if at all he wear anything, it's Amangal. He wearing snake, he wearing deer skin, he wearing ashes from the burial, from the cremation site. That's what he does wear. All about. And snake everywhere. It have many people who are Shiva devotees today, they wear snake and think they walk about him. In America, there are many people wearing snake. People like snake. They're following many things from the old. Aguna, Amana, Matu Pitu Hina. Aguna means no great qualities. Amana, no, of course, you don't have any man, any great pride or anything. Then, Matu Pitu Hina, no mara, no fara. When Parvati go to marry he, who go do mora and fara and thing now? You ever hear Lord Shiva mora and fara? No. Udasin. Udasin means he's always aloof by himself somewhere. When he's a runaway and gone, they say he's gone sit down in the cremation site. He's called Udasin, all by himself, aloof. That type of quality. Sabha samsaya china. I mean to say that he always will cause doubt in the mind of everybody. What type of person is this? Like that. Yeah, he wearing snake and ashes from this cremation site and he want no clothes and he want no, he had no house too. Asa swami ehi kai milihi. Ka milihi. This type of husband she go get. That written in she hand. Yes. Now see, now Himawan hear this thing now. Oh God. My little Munni. Huh? My little baby good. That kind of husband she go get. That fella wearing snake and Jatil, Jogi. He pay no attention to his wife, nothing. Suni Muni Gira Satya Jani. Knowing that the Muni also is 100% right, because the Muni cannot be, he's Sarvagya. He knows everything, past, present, future, Trikalagya. Dukha Dampatihi Uma Harishani. Dukha Dampati means, Dampati means husband and wife. Husband and wife became totally overwhelmed by sorrow. Look now, they're hearing this thing, the daughter is young age, what kind of destiny she have now? Now, whole life they could be miserable or not. You see, that's what I tell you, this thing come in the beginning, like that. Whole life now you, miserable. Second thing, when you, see, miserable. Now, two of them miserable like anything. Second thing, they're going to try everything to avoid that eventuality, isn't it? First thing, you're miserable, you're trying everything to avoid that. And look here, you can't turn around, just an arrow tell that. Nobody could change karma. Karma is? Karma. So they could try all kind of things to avert that, but now, dukkha dampatihi, the wife and husband became so miserable. And Maina was her word, name. Himawan and Maina. Then, Uma Harishani. But Parvati Uma, she was happy. Oh, that can only mean that my husband will be Lord Shiva. She happy. Because who else will have that description? So she happy, but the parents miserable. But there's another thing here. All parents have dreams for their children, correct or not? Look, I tell you, me have no children, but I know that. All parents have dreams for their children, correct or not? That is ill-founded, eh? That is ill-founded, and that is a source of sorrow. Dreams for the children is a source of sorrow. And you know what happened? The dreams are never fulfilled. And let me tell you, if it perchance gets fulfilled. See, look here. The parents have a dream for their child, right? So that dream is never fulfilled, then the parents' heart get broken. If perchance that dream gets fulfilled, then the child's heart gets broken. Because the parents will force him or her to follow their dream. And when that child follows their dream, that child will not be happy because that was not his dream. So if it is fulfilled, the child is miserable. If it is not fulfilled, the parent is miserable. The Shastra doesn't tell about dream like that for children. But the Shastra tell about parenting, very simple thing. Each child comes with his own karma, and he is going to be what he is destined to be. The parent's work is only to provide him with all of the necessities that are required in a society for bringing up a proper child. You send him to school, you provide school books and uniform and food and protection for him and all of that thing. But that is like, you know, the example of Puja Guruji is a very nice example. Look here. You get a little flower plant by your neighbor, right? But you know it has pink hibiscus, white hibiscus, red hibiscus, yellow hibiscus, all kind of hibiscus it has, right? But you get a hibiscus plant from your neighbor, but you don't know what color it is, right? You bring home the hibiscus plant. You plant it there. You put a little protection around it because the cow will come and eat it if you don't protect it. So you put a little protection around it there. Then you give it some fertilizer, some manure, some water, and this and that. You give it everything that the plant needs. But can you tell that plant what color flower to give? You can't. The plant is destined to give only a certain color of flower. And you will know when it flowers. That time you will know. Well, it was destined to give. But you had the duty of providing the protection, providing the manure, providing the fertilizer, providing the water, providing sunlight. You have to make sure it is blocked by other trees. So our duty is to provide whatever the child needs, and whatever the child is destined to be, the child will be that thing only.
Look here, how much are countless people sit down here who know me as a little boy running all about here playing marble and cricket running. Anyone all you think I will become a swami? Eh? You see? I myself I know. When we playing cricket here with Lovey and playing in the backyard in night, the place dark, you can't see the ball and you're still playing. And whoever think, you see, but everybody will become what they are destined to become. Eh? So now parents' misery comes and parents have too many dreams for their children. Anyway, parent duty is provide everything for the child. Let the child become what they were destined to become. See, parenting is very simple. Parent complicate parenting. Complicate parenting. Because they have too many dreams. I travel this whole world, I've seen everywhere. I met somebody, you study? Yeah, I went to university. Why you study? Psychology. What are you going to do with a psychology degree? Me and my mother make me study that. Because my mother like psychology. Child miserable, but the mother happy. Because my child study psychology. Wrong parenting. Real cases I'm telling. So, provide everything for the... Actually, one of the most wonderful things, I have a most wonderful mother. In my final year of university, she called me. She paying for the education, eh? She called me. She said, tell me where you're studying now. My friend and them asking. Tell me where you're studying, because them asking me, I know what to tell them. She ain't no self. Yeah. Wonderful thing. So, the parents who have dreams for their children, they get misery. Parents who take up the duty of parenting properly and just provide for the child, guide the child, and if it provides secular education as well as spiritual education, both. Eh? And today, in today's world, parents only providing secular education, and so what you get is an educated fool. Yes, a person without spirituality, and this same fellow who will be elected to some office, and the same fellow who's swindling all the money and taking it everywhere. He educated. All the corruption, he's an educated man. The common man who's not educated, he and all them ropes. So, we need to provide that child with secular education, and also spiritually. You see how wonderfully Gautam and the people here, they are making sure these children come on a Sunday morning and they learn something substantial in Bal Vihar and all that. Raji, I'm working so hard for this. This is important. The spiritual side of that child. A child has like two wings, a secular and a spiritual. You ever see any bird flying with one wing? So, this is about parenting and parental expectations here now, and that leads to a lot of misery. And our parent could very easily avoid that misery. But Parvati is happy because she knows that description fits Lord Shiva. This fellow is homeless, clothesless, moneyless. He have nothing. Yes, everything. Narada hu yaha bheda na jana. Now, Nara did not know. What a wonderful thing. This line is so wonderful. Dasa ek samujhava bilagana. What the line means is this thing. Nara told one single thing to both the parents and to the daughter. That she will marry a husband like this who homeless and he had nothing, you know, penniless and everything. Nara told the same thing to both the people. But that same thing make one miserable and make one happy. Welcome to the world. Welcome to this jagat. The same thing in this world can make one person miserable and make one person happy. What that tells about this world is a truism. And that is the happiness or the joy is not in the thing.
The happiness or the joy is in one own heart. Because if the happiness or the joy was in the thing, it should make everybody happy. Like how the heat in the fire. The fire will burn everybody. Fire doesn't only burn one person. Because the heat inheres in the fire. But happiness does not inhere in objects and things of the world. So the same thing in the world will give one person misery and give one person joy. That's because it is the person's response to the thing in the world. One looks at something in the world and responds with sorrow. Another one looks at the thing in the world and responds with joy. The response is from within only. This is a truism about the world, a very fundamental fact about the world. So now, the same thing, Tulsidashi uses old principle and puts it nice in Avati Chaupai and all that. But Tulsidashi has captured all the truisms of the Upanishads. And he has put it in all these simple lines. Sakala sakhi girija giri maina pulaka sarira bhare jalane. All of them were crying now. The mother and father crying out of sorrow. And Girija crying out of happiness. See? All of them crying also now. You never know, in this world some people cry out of joy, some people cry out of sorrow. Some people don't know why they're crying. Next type also. Crying is a real funny thing too. Siddhaji described crying in this Ramayana in many places. Eh? He talks about the art of crying also. Tulsidashi, the art of crying. When you cry, you can't just stand at attention and cry, man. No, you stand up there straight. Like that. He described how you have to cry. Everything is described in his Ramayana. But in the world, you see people cry out of joy and you see people cry out of sorrow. When you want to see that, you have to see the World Cup football match. Eh? Correct or not? All them who win, them crying one side. All them who lose, them crying. Next side. Hoi namesha devarishi bhasha uma so bachana. Uma so bachana. Hridaya dhari rakha. Now, Narada, see, Uma kept up those words in her heart and said, the rishi's word cannot be false. Rishi's word have to be true. And like that, upajeo seva padas kamala sanehu milana katina mana bhasandehu. In her heart, a great love for the Lord of Lord Shiva arose in her heart, but she thought, but it will be very difficult to reach him. It will be very difficult to reach him. And now jani kuavasaru priti durai sakhi uchanga Baitamuni Jai. At that time, she did not tell anybody about her love for Lord Shiva. She kept it in her own heart. Jhutana hoi devarishi pani. Devarishi's word cannot be false at all. So chahi dampati sakhi sayani. The parents now also saying Devarishi's word cannot be false. She just said Devarishi and she's happy. The parents say Devarishi's word cannot be false and they're miserable. Saying the same thing. Uradhari thir kahai ki rau kahu nat ka kariya upau. Now, I told you, when the parents find out the bad things, now tell some means to avert this thing. They tell Narada now. Tell some means now. See? Narada put himself in trouble. Because he tell all the bad things and now they ask now. Tell some means to avert that. So she'll not get such a kind of husband. Kahamunis himavanta sunu jo bidhi likha lila. Whatever destiny has written for all of us, he said, Deva, Danuj, Nara, Nag, Muni, Kouna metahi nihar. Meti nihar. I mean, nobody could change that thing. Narada say, tell to Himavant, my dear, you jump high or jump low. But whatever the Lord has written, nobody could erase that. She will, whether you do what you want, she will marry that type of husband. And he telling him, I'm telling Narada, you please find someone. No upaya, there is nothing I could do. Now the parents miserable. What Narada could do?
for them guru, that we have to see tomorrow. All right. Now, I know we lost one of the members of the community here yesterday, even while the satsang was going on. So, just to do a small presentation in memory of... Who is coming? In memory of the departed, who was a member of this community and who is, was there in the previous yajnas and all them things.
Sitaram, Hari Om. Our distinguished Swami Prakashananda, Pandit Deepak Maharaj, our dear Pandit Dudna Chedi, and Uncle Terry, it is such an honor to have your blessing each night at this home, particularly because each of you are very near and dear to our hearts. So we say thank you. A special welcome to all other Pandits, our counselor, Mrs. Kemwati Chulan, and other community leaders present here tonight, and to all of our friends and family. Thank you for sharing in these hours of prayer. I am sure it will have a lasting impact on improving our hearts and minds and raising the vibration of this community. It is often said that it takes a village to raise a child, and I can speak with utmost certainty for the younger members of this organization and myself, that we would not be who we are today if it weren't for this little village of Roshad Road, and more specifically, the people in it. People like our beloved Auntie Malti, who has played such a pivotal role in our development and upbringing. Auntie Malti has shaped the lives of every single member of this organization by assuming the role of a motherly figure, a friend, and a confidant. Before leaving this physical world, though she may not be here in body, she is definitely present in spirit. Auntie Malti had a gentle heart and a kind and only kind words to speak about others. She never indulged in any idle talk or practices. She was in fact a very hard-working and constructive person in every way. She was also an excellent cook, a devoted wife, and a selfless mother, not to only her own children, but to many others in this village, including the children of this organization. She never complained about her circumstances, and we may truly never know the struggles she endured to ensure her family's well-being, even during the period of her ailment. She never lost hope in this life and her belief in God. She lived a very simple and modest lifestyle, sacrificing her time, energy, and effort to put others first.
Her life is indeed a reminder to all of us that time is a precious gift from our Creator, and what we do with this life is our gift to all of His creation. After Auntie's passing, it became very clear to us that we will not be remembered for our material possessions, but in fact, we would be remembered for the effect that we have on others. This immediately drew my memory to one of Swamiji's lectures many years ago, where he said, every thought we think, every word we speak, every action that we take causes a ripple into this infinite cosmos. Every action that we take, therefore, creates an everlasting effect on our reality, and it produces a new world for ourselves and all those in it. This is mirrored in the life of our dear auntie, who in a very simple way has shaped our lives without even realizing it, by simply being herself. She has demonstrated her power in being gentle and living kindly, dedicating her life to bettering her family and performing service to our humble community, and in so doing, has changed all of our lives. In our scriptures, it is said that the soul can never be cut into pieces by any weapon, Nor can it be burned by fire, nor moistened by water, nor withered by the wind. The soul is everlasting, invisible, inconceivable, and unchangeable. Knowing this, we should not grieve. Therefore, as time passes, we should not mourn her loss, but celebrate her life and her message, this gift that she has left behind to all of us. Though through the love that we share for each other as a community and an extended family, her message will live on as we remember each day to think better thoughts, to speak kindly to one another, to have faith and courage, just like Auntie has taught us. The loved ones our loved ones are therefore always with us in every sunset, every raindrop, every clear blue sky. They send the message, I am here. Let us please share a moment of silence as we join in our love and appreciation for the life of Auntie Malti. And at this time, we also would like to remember the precious life of our Auntie Mohani. The news of her passing was a very sudden blow to all of us. Auntie was like a sister to my parents, to all my uncles, my aunts, and all of the senior members of this organization. She was also a very irreplaceable mother figure to all of us. So please join me in this moment of silent prayer. Thank you. I am sure that these two beautiful souls are smiling with us tonight. My younger brothers and sisters have prepared a very beautiful song which they would like to dedicate to the immediate families of these two amazing souls. To Uncle Matt, Linda, Andy, Bola, Tikaram, Rudy, and Samantha, you will always find a family here at this home and within this organization. Thank you.
Tu kitni achhi hai, tu kitni ho gayi.
Most illustrious gentleman who was brought up, who grew up just like all of us, and he has made it all the way up to the pinnacles of administration in Trinidad and Tobago, and I'm sure all of you would have seen him many times on television. I'm speaking about Dr. Stephen Ramroop, who is the former head of the ODPM in Trinidad and Tobago, and who was at that time in touch with all the protective services and all the different arms of government, and was responsible for coordinating any responses to disasters and calamities and all. Dr. Ramroop is with us here tonight. I would like to invite him to just come and share a few words with us. Dr. Ramroop is also one of Trinidad and Tobago's most skilled surgeon and former head of his department in the San Fernando Hospital. And such people who have come up the ranks have made great contributions to our nation. Dr. Ramroop.
Hariom. Thanks, Swami. Pundits. Devotees, thanks very much for allowing me to say a few words. It's always very nice to see people attend very learned sessions. And I remember on Tuesday at around 5:31 p.m., I was making some pumpkin soup. See, at my home, we have a Rotary club. I'm a Rotarian for 32 years. We serve the community. But on Tuesday, we were making some pumpkin soup for them to eat later on. But it's not about them, really. As I was stirring the pumpkin soup, at around 5:31, I actually felt the pumpkin soup was stirring me. Because, you know, everything started to shake. And I remember when I was in Mexico a few years ago, they had an earthquake. And we were in one of the diplomatic centers, and the president and a lot of the ambassadors were there, a lot of heads of state, and we evacuated that place in less than a minute, 2 minutes. So much so that a chandelier actually fell where one of the presidents were standing. So my Dharampatni came around, and you know, I always tell Swami, every time I tell her about things, you know, like death and, you know, karma and consciousness, she don't believe me at all, but when our guru says it, she believes me. But on that day, she ran to me and she believed me, and I said, come, let's go under the strongest part of that room, which was a doorway. And we stood there and we looked at the house shake, and we saw the swimming pool, all the water came around, and the whole place was shaking. while some other persons were outside laughing, who didn't know what danger they were in. I spent 6 years in ODPM, and I must have actually invested over $80 million of Trinidad dollars in those 6 years to train people, to educate people, and to tell them what to do. And Swami, you said something about people, when Narad was telling them about the baby. You see, some people will take the good things out of things, some people will take the bad things out of things. But you guys are so lucky because you experienced a 6.8 to 7 earthquake in this country, every one of you, even children. And that is an experience that some of the adults here didn't even have until then. It also goes to tell you that the whole of Trinidad is prone to an earthquake, not just the fault lines, everywhere. So you have to look at it as good. Some of these will look at bad. I'll tell you how we look at it as good and bad. If you look on the internet, you will see that a lot of people run out of their homes. Trinidadians run out. Trinidadians took pictures of videos of what was happening. And Trinidadians posted it on Facebook. Whereas what we're supposed to do was really, we should drop, we should cover, get under a very safe place like my Dharampatni and I did. Watch all your idiots get prepared for death. And when they die, we will go safely, right, and help them. How many of you all ran? How many of you all just stood dazed and say, oh my God, when is this going to happen? And you were confused. How many people, and you saw, I actually saw a doctor was actually outside of Mount Hope on the green compound, and all the patients were on the beds, and all the staff were in the corridors. In Trinidad and Tobago, they leave the patients who are the vulnerable ones on the beds, they run out into the corridors, and some of the doctors even came outside. That's to tell you how prepared we are. But I went to Japan, and I went to Haiti. Haiti had the same earthquake, except that we are so lucky. Their earthquake was just about 20 kilometers east of the city. Ours were about 47 kilometers east of our city. Theirs were 20 kilometers to 10 kilometers above the ground, below the ground, and we were 47 kilometers below the ground, which means that we are so lucky that we actually experienced something, but we must learn. And we must learn to understand. If there's a fire here or an explosion, you run. If there's an earthquake, right, you have to get to a safe place within the compound because according to the science, most people are killed and injured when they run outside because that's where the blocks will fall and hit you. Now, I just want to say one thing because Swami talked about bowing. I went to Japan and these people bow. When you go into a store, they will bow and they will say hello in Japanese, which I can't say really. Yeah. And when you're leaving the store, they will bow. But there was one set of bowing that I was very interested in. When a husband goes out to drink the night and fete and he comes home, the normal bow of the Japanese is like this. When the husband comes and he does that, he has to bow like that. So I didn't know, and I asked, well, why are you bowing like that? He said, when you come home, you have to bow like that. But that is how they do it. The Japanese are so beautiful. When we went to the centers, they actually have little children who pack their disaster bags. They teach them to do that. How many of you all, since Tuesday, have actually gone back now and packed your bag? Because when you have to evacuate your house with all the no power, no water, right? Your food will spoil after 2 days, and they will take you to a shelter. So what are you going to do? Do you have your bag ready to go? Now, these are the things that we tell you. And everybody here has a phone, and everybody goes into Facebook. You should really log on to the ODPM website. Although since I left, they were not doing much again, but at least the website is still there. But remember the Japanese. They don't run, they don't take the pictures, and they don't post it on Facebook. What they do, they have common sense. And I think that we understand after today what Narad was telling the father. You see, you have to look at both sides of the thing. There is positive and negative. You take the positive of what happened on Tuesday, and you have to thank God for that. Yes? But at the same time, you have to be prepared because we didn't get a big one. We are lucky because our construction is not that bad, but our common sense is not that good. So, thank you. You know, it's always a pleasure to say a few words after you. Thank you very much. God bless.
Thank you.
आरती के लिए सब खड़े हो जाइए।